Dominic Raab has been handed day-to-day decision-making by Prime Minister Boris Johnson. Raab was effectively Johnson's deputy, serving as Foreign Secretary and First Secretary of State. While Johnson remains Prime Minister, Raab is now leading the country. So who is Dominic Raab? The 46-year-old is a former lawyer and staunch Brexiteer. Raab himself wanted to be head of the Conservative Party.
And the candidate who can be trusted to deliver on Brexit. And then unite our party behind an optimistic vision, fitting for our great country and worthy of our great people.
But he lacked enough support from other MPs last year and didn't make it past the second round of voting. Raab quickly endorsing Johnson, a move that would land him the position of Foreign Secretary in Johnson's cabinet.
Hugely humbled to take on this role at this time and excited about the opportunities that lie ahead. Obviously, we've got the challenges of Brexit, but that's something that we want as a country to rise to.
Brexit was an important stepping stone in Raab's career. In July 2018, he was made Brexit Secretary under then-Prime Minister Theresa May, but quit the post after 4 months, saying he could not get behind May's Brexit plan. In recent weeks, Raab has increasingly focused on the coronavirus.
UK travellers abroad now face widespread international border restrictions and lockdowns in various countries.
The pandemic, now a monumental battle in the UK, is putting unexpected responsibilities on Raab. As Boris Johnson continues his deeply serious personal fight against the virus in a London ICU. Nick Robertson, CNN, London.
Carol Walker is a political analyst, of course. She joins us from here in London. I've met him, you've met him. Describe the character Dominic Raab, because I don't think there's any doubt, is there, that he's up to the job currently.
Well, Dominic Raab, as you heard in that report, is someone who has had quite significant experience in some challenging roles, not least when he was Brexit Secretary before he resigned from Theresa May's cabinet. But I have to say that I think that when we heard the update last night that the Prime Minister had been taken into intensive care, Dominic Raab did appear somewhat shaken. And I think that that news really did send shockwaves through Downing Street. The Prime Minister, of course, was taken into hospital, as you know, on Sunday after suffering from the coronavirus for some 9 days, still suffering with the cough, still suffering with the high temperature. At that time, Dominic Raab was simply chairing meetings in his place. And clearly, Dominic Raab has now had to take on a great deal more responsibility. In the UK, we don't have the same formal system that you have, for example, in the United States, where there is a formal deputy's role. But Dominic Raab has been designated as the most senior minister who's going to deputize for the prime minister. He will once again this morning be chairing the key committee meeting to consider the next steps on the coronavirus. Although even last night, even after the prime minister was taken into intensive care, Dominic Raab was insisting that he was carrying out the instructions of Boris Johnson and that there was a strong team there at the top of government that were going to be carrying out the plans that had been agreed. And of course, there are very senior health officials, experts in the field of immunology, the virus, yep, its spread and so on, who have a key role to play as well.
But you're highlighting one of the issues here, which has come up, hasn't it, over the last 12 hours, because obviously Dominic Raab's position here goes back to the fact he was appointed, you know, some time ago as First Minister. That role steps in for the Prime Minister if he becomes incapacitated, but no one expected that to happen. So Dominic Raab wasn't obviously being appointed in that light. And there isn't this formal succession plan in the UK as there is in the US. And aren't we now in a situation where there could potentially be a conflict where it's not entirely clear where Boris Johnson is in charge, where Dominic Raab is in charge, and if there are any divisions that set in behind the scenes that could potentially cause a real problem for leadership in the country?
Well, look, clearly there isn't that same formal arrangement as you have pointed out. I think what is clear is that Dominic Raab has been designated into this role. I think the sense of shock that there has been through the top echelons of government at the rapid developments and the worsening of Boris Johnson's condition yesterday afternoon means that I think that for the time being, at least, ministers will simply want to pull together. We have had suggestions that there are tensions within Downing Street between some senior ministers, some civil servants, different departments who have different priorities. But I think that what has happened now may well actually mean that those tensions will be set aside and that people will be really pulling out all the stops to try to make sure that they do work as a team while Boris Johnson is in hospital, in intensive care. I think even before yesterday's development, some people had been concerned that while he was not well, he, Boris Johnson, was still trying too hard to try to manage the government. And indeed, at the press briefing at 5 o'clock yesterday afternoon, Dominic Raab was making the point that Boris Johnson was still looking at his red boxes, which of course carry the vital government papers of the day, that he was still going through there, that he was still at that stage in charge of the government. But then, of course, 3 hours later, Dominic Raab popped up on television again to tell us, well, he has now been taken into intensive care. And clearly, the Prime Minister will need a period of recuperation. And I think that is where it may become more difficult. At the moment, many of the key decisions have been taken about the scale of the lockdown across the country, about the efforts to try to get testing in place, particularly for key health workers. But in about a week from now, there is due to be a review of that lockdown. And I think the question then is who will be making the key decisions as to whether or not it will be possible at all to ease some of the restrictions. Although I should add the rider that the word that we were getting from those very senior health officials yesterday seemed to suggest that it was very, very unlikely that there could be any easing of those restrictions anytime soon. So it may well be that there will be time, we hope, for the Prime Minister to recuperate, to get right back into Downing Street, to regain the reins of power fully before some of those bigger decisions are taken. And in the meantime, I think the real hope is that the different government ministers with their different responsibilities coming together in this key COVID-19 committee will be able to continue along the general path that's been set out by Boris Johnson.